Hello friends, welcome back in my YouTube channel. It's a random series and today session 2. And today I'm going to start with how to install the Django. This particular series, the random series I'm talking about, it's based on the demand. It's based on the certain requirements. Some demand is there regarding the Django installation. So today I'm going to start with the installation of Django, how to install the Django and all. I'm not going to cover the things in the detail, like what exactly the Django is, what about the Pythons and all. This is simply the Django installation. Django is basically what? It's a kind of Python web framework. Python is just the language. It's the language for the future. It's the modern language at present, and it's in highly demand. And Django is what? It's a kind of web framework for the Python. So if someone want to develop the websites and all in Python, what we need to use? We need to use the Django for that. So Django is basically, it's a Python web framework. And today I'm going to start with how to install the Django. So first of all, the certain requirements are there regarding the installation. We just need to follow this step. The first thing that we need to consider is Python must be installed over there. So at first we need to check. We need to install the Python. So how to install the Python? To install the Python, what we need to do, there is a website called www.python.org.downloads. In this particular website you will get the link for the Python installation. So at first what we need to do, just we need to visit on this particular website, python.org/downloads. In this particular website you will get the link for download Python 3.7.3. This is the latest version of the Python you can download. We can download the Python for the different operating systems. Python is basically, it's a kind of cross-platform particular language. So we can go for the Python installation for the Windows, for the Linux, for the Mac. So at present I'm going for the Windows. So what I need to do, I just need to click on this download Python 3.7.3. this is the latest version. When you click on the download, you will the file will be available within the download folder. This is the file we are having. Now what we need to do, we just need to click on this particular file and it will get installed. That's it. We just need to click on this file and it will get installed. Now Python is ready with my system, so I need to check whether the Python is installed or not. So how to start the Python, how we can check it? I'm just going to write IDLE. This is what exactly, this is the IDE for the Python. I'm just going to click on this and you will be there in the Python environment. This is the environment of the Python. Python is a simple language. Suppose I'm going to write print. I'm going to write print welcome. This is your first program in Python. Okay, I'm not going to talk about the Python and all. So this is what the Python is installed with my system. Now after the Python installation, the second thing that we need to do, we need to set the path. We need to set the path. And this is the most important thing. As a fresher, normally it's a huge problem to how to set the path with the Pythons and all. So what I need to do, I need to set the path for the Python. I need to set the path for the pip. Pip is basically Python package installer. Python package installer. So what I need to do, I just need to set the path. So how we can set the path for the Python? Path means what? Suppose I'm going to start the command prompt, it's cmd. In this command prompt I'm going to write the Python. I'm just going to write the Python over there, and we are just getting Python is not recognized as an internal or external command, operable program or batch file. So what I need to do first, at first I need to install the, I need to set the path. So this is how we can set the path. At first I am just writing IDLE. This is what I am writing. I am just going to click on this, right click, open file location. This is basically the shortcut. I need to go to the exact location of this Python. So what I can do, right click, open the file location. This is the location of your Python folders and all. These are the files. So what I need to do, I just need to copy this path. control C, and I'm just going to put this path over this location, and one path is also there, it's required for me. I just need to click on this script folder. This script folder contains the pip, it contains the nginstall. These are the installer, basically it's a Python package installer is there. I need to set the path for this also, and so I'm just going to copy this path also. Now what I need to do, I'm just going to close this. Now what I'm going to do, right click on this, my computer, this PC, I'm just going to right click on this, properties, advanced system setting, yes. Now I'm going to click on this environment variables. In the environment variable, I'm just going to click on this path. Path is there. Now what I need to do, I need to set the path. So I'm just going to click on this edit. And at last what I need to do in this particular portion, at last what I need to do, I'm just going to write semicolon over there, and I'm just going to copy this. I'm just going to copy this path over there, control C, and going to paste this one. Again, I'm going to put the semicolon over there, and again, I'm going to use this, control C, and this one. Click on this, okay, okay, okay. Now your path gets set. How we can identify the path gets set or not? I'm just going to start with the command prompt, and I'm going to write pip. Yeah, my path is installed over there. Suppose I'm going to write Python, it's working for me. So this is the important thing, how to set the path. I'm just going to change the color of screens and all. So this is how we can set the path. Now what I need to do, we just need to follow these steps. So first thing, we need to set the path. We need to set these two paths. Now what we need to do, I'm just going to open the command prompt. Suppose right now we are in the C drive. If I want to go to the D drive or E drive, so I'm just going to start with the E drive. It's in the E drive, or we can go for the particular drive. You can move in the any drive, it's not necessary to go for the D drive or E drive, it depends on your availability and all. So at present I'm in the E drive. Now what I need to do, at first I need to check whether the Python is installed over there or not, and what the versions we are having of the Python. So just we can write Python, I'm just writing Python hyphen hyphen version, and we are getting the version of the Python. It's 3.7.3, it's installed over there. Now what I need to do, I need to install the Django. So how we can install the Django? This is the command that I need to write. I am writing Python minus m, Python minus m, and I'm going to write pip install Django. This is how we can install the Django. Python minus m, pip install Django. Sorry, spelling mistake is there. I'm just going to write Python minus m, pip install Django. Now Django is going to install with my system. Some problem is there, could not install package due to environment error. Let me check once again. This is the command that you need to write, Python minus m pip install Django. This is the command we can use over there. I'm just going to write tg underscore install Django. This is also the command we can use. We can also use the tg underscore install Django, or we can use Python minus m pip install Django. it's installing at my system. And one important thing is that when we install, like this is the command that we need to write. The command is, like, we are in the E drive. What we need to write? We need to write Python minus m pip install Django. Otherwise, we can also use eg underscore install Django. One important thing is that when you install the Django, required internet. So your net should be connected over there. Yeah, it's get installed in my system. So either we can use Python minus m pip install Django, otherwise we can also use eg install Django. And once at the time of installation, what we required, the internet connection over there, because it will get copy the data from the different sites. Now the next thing what we need to do, I need to check what the versions we are having of the Django. So I'm just writing Django --admin --version, and this is the versions we are having of the Django, like Django --admin --version. So Django is installed with my system, Python is already over there. Now what I need to do, I need to create the project in Django. I need to create project. So how we can start the project? Python is already installed over there, Django is already installed over there. Now I need to create the project in the Django. Project means what? I want to create the website. In Django, the website, it's a project. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create the project first. I'm just going to write Django, Django --admin. We always need to consider the spaces and all. I'm writing Django --admin. As such, there is no any space. Now we are writing start project, and I'm going to create the project by the name of test1. When we apply the dir command in the E drive, there is a folder called test1. So now what we need to do, we just need to visit in this particular directory. So I'm just writing cd test1. So now we are in this particular project. When we apply the dir command over there, these are the files, we don't need to bother about this. So this is the first command that we need to write, Django --admin start project test1. After that, this is the command that we need to do, cd test1. Now we are in this working directory. Now what I need to do, I need to create the apps. In Django, the pages is known as the apps. So what I need to do, I need to create the apps. So how we can do this? I'm just writing python manage.py, and I'm writing the command start app. Suppose I'm going to create the app by the name of contact. This is the page that I need to create, python manage.py start app contact. Now write down the command dir. We are having the contact folder over there, so it's basically kind of app is there. So now what I need to do, my project is ready. My project means the website. My app is ready means my web pages. Now what I need to do, remember, the advantage of the Django is it provides you the admin interfaces automatically. For the admin and all, we don't need to write the code. So what we can do now, I'm just going to write python manage.py migrate. This is basically the command I'm going to use. This migrate command will create the tables and all. It's required for the admin, like user table, forget password table, password table, like the complete user interfaces will be there. In that particular user interface, the background, some table will be there. So it will create the table for you. Remember, Django by default support SQLite databases. So when we install the Django, even when you install the Python, it's automatically installed the SQLite.
SQLite is the database that we need to consider. In Django, by default database is the SQLite, so it will automatically create the SQLite databases over there. So I am just going to write python manage.py migrate. See, we are getting the messages like the table get created over there, authentication, initialization, like these are the table, alter user username, alter user last login. So these are the table. I will discuss this table in further video and all. So this is what we need to write, python manage.py migrate. Now project is ready, apps is ready, table is ready for you. Now what we need to do, I am just going to write, when we start the server and all, again it's required, if suppose I'm looking for the admin login. So once again I'm going to create the add super user over there, python manage.py create super user, create super user, asking for the username. I'm just going to give the username like Santos. Yeah, you need to give the email address. You can give any mail ID over there. Password, suppose I'm going to give 123. Again, I'm going to give the password 123. Basically, password validation, lot of things are there. I'm just going to bypass this. So you want to create the user ID anyway? Yeah, I'm going to create with that. So super user created successfully. So project is ready, apps is ready, table is ready, user is ready. Now you are ready to start your server. So I'm going to start my server, python manage.py, and I'm just going to write run server. It will start the server for you. Yeah, my server gets started. Now what I need to do, this is the URL that we need to remember. I'm just going to copy this URL and just going to open the browser, and in this particular browser I'm just going to write this URL. Remember, to start the Django, the most important thing always is we need to follow the steps. Number one. Number two, to open the websites and all, always we need to start the server. So this is your first interface. Now if you are getting this kind of page over there, means what? Everything is fine. Now you can start your work. So this is the first page we are having. Okay, admin panel was there with me, like it's automatic over there. So I'm just going to write slash admin, Django administration. You need to give the username. I'm going to give the username over there. Suppose I'm writing, my username was super user Santos and my password was 123. Click on this and we are getting all these panels over there. These panel automatically get created by the Django. So the Django admin panel will be there for you. Suppose I need to create the user. Click on this. See, these are the files. You can create the username and all. Suppose I am going to click on this. We are getting the name of the user, the email address and all. Even you can filter the things. So lot of things are there. And by the writing of simply 5 or 6 line over there, you are getting this admin panel now. Suppose I want to get the add the user. So everything is there. Suppose I am going to give the username and all, password and all. See, all these validations are there. So this is how we can start the installation of the Django, how we can start with the Django project, how we can start the server. So I am just going to click on this Control C. So this is all about the Django installation. This is how you can start your Django programming. So this is the first lesson of the Django, how to install the Django, how to start the server, how to process the work and all. Now for further, what you need to do for the Django, the best IDE that you can work for, it's a PyCharm. So what you need to do, you just need to install the PyCharm over there, and through the PyCharm you can work with the Django and all. So this is all about the Django installation, how to install the Django, how to start the project. So everything is there with you.
And what you need to do, you just need to go through the step-by-step installations and configuration. In case of any problem, in case of any suggestion, you can give your comments. You can also subscribe the channel, give me some feedback. Your likes and your comments, it's really highly appreciated. Thanks a lot. And once again, if having a specific demand, you can ask me for that particular video in your comment box. Definitely, I will provide you the video for that. Thanks a lot. Enjoy.